वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स स्टूडेंट्स टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी टू थ्योरम्स ऑन कंटिन्यूअस फंक्शन इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी सॉ दैट अ फंक्शन इज कंटिन्यूअस इफ एंड ओनली इफ इनवर्स इमेज ऑफ ओपन सेट इज ओपन इन मैट्रिक्स स्पेसेस ओके सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द कंटिन्यूटी ऑफ फंक्शन व्हेन द गिवन सेट इज क्लोज ओके दैट इज वी आर गोइंग टू सी द थ्योरम इफ इज कंटिन्यूअस इफ एंड ओनली इफ inverse image of closed set is closed here. So statement of that theorem is this. Theorem, let xd and y row be matrix spaces. And f from x to y be a function then function f is continuous if and only if if inverse image of set f okay or that is f inverse f is closed set in x whenever set f is closed in y that is we want to show that inverse image of closed set is closed when function f is continuous and when we have inverse image of closed set is closed then that function is continuous so we are going to see now proof of this theorem in this in first part we are going to take f from x to y as continuous function and f is closed set in y here then we are going to show that f inverse f is closed in set x here so let f be a continuous function so f be continuous and this set capital F be closed in y Now, since this set is closed in Y, so it means that its complement is open in Y. So we write here, then the complement of F is open in Y here. And therefore, actually we write inverse image of this set is open in x because we know that function f is continuous here so by using previous theorem we know that inverse image of open set is open so we write here and therefore f inverse of complement of f or inverse image of complement of f is open in x here but actually here we have this set is the complement of f inverse f here okay so we write here since f inverse f now this set is the complement of inverse image of this set that is complement of f okay f inverse f is complement of f inverse complement of f in x here and now this set is closed here so yes inverse image of the complement of f is open here okay so this tells us that now this set is closed here so therefore we write here f inverse f capital f is closed set in x so hence
when function f from x to y is continuous, then okay, inverse image of closed set is closed here. Now for the converse part, now in converse part we are going to take as f inverse f is closed set in x whenever f is closed in y. So conversely, suppose that f inverse f is closed in x whenever f is closed in y. Now we want to show that here function f is continuous. F is continuous. That is, we are going to prove that. Now inverse image of open set is open by using this. So we write here, let G be an open set or an open subset of the matrix space Y. Then obviously the complement of this set will be closed. So then the complement of set G is closed in Y. Okay, and by our hypothesis, now this set is closed, so its inverse image should be closed in X. So by hypothesis, we write here inverse image of complement of G is closed in X. Now we know that now this set, okay, actually inverse image of complement of set G is the complement of F inverse G, okay, in X here. And we know that this set is closed in X. So by using the same argument that we have used earlier, so we can say that F inverse G is open in X here. So therefore we write here F inverse G is open in X, because we know that F inverse G is the complement of this set, which is the inverse image of complement of G. And since this set is closed, so therefore we write F inverse G is open in X. Now here we have G as an open subset of Y, okay, so we have taken here G as an open set and we have shown that here F inverse G is open in X. So when we have this type of statement, so we say that in that case function F is continuous. So we write here, hence F is continuous, because we know that if inverse image of open set is open, then in that case that function is continuous. So hence we write here function F is continuous. Now the next theorem is that, actually in that theorem we are going to show that function F is continuous if and only if now image of closure of a set is contained in closure of image of that set. So we are going to see that. So next theorem is this. So theorem, let x comma d and y comma rho be matrix spaces and f from function f from x to y be a function, then this function f
okay, f is continuous. Continuous. If and only if. If and only if. F of closure of A is containing closure of F of A. For every subset A, capital A of X. So we are going to talk about continuity when closure of a set is given. Okay, so first is that, now we are going to use the previous theorem and the closure property here. So first we are going to assume that a function f is continuous. So let f be continuous. Okay, then we write here, now inverse image of, now this set, inverse image of closure of f of A is closed set in X, because we know that this set contains all its limit points and we know that this one, since f of A closure is closed set in Y. So I already told you, now this set contains all its limit points, so that's why this set is closed. Okay, now we have f of A, now this set is always subset of just closure of f of A. So this implies that, okay, if we apply F inverse on both the sides, so we write A is contained in, yes, inverse image of, yes, closure of F of A. So this implies that we write A closure, so taking closure on both the sides, so we write here A closure is contained in, now F inverse of closure of F of A here. But we know that now this set is closed. Okay, but now this set, F inverse of closure of F of A, or inverse image of closure of F of A, now this set is closed set. So therefore we write here A closure, now this is contained in, now we write here F inverse of F of A closure. Okay, so we write now this one, so this implies that, okay, applying F on both the sides, so we write here F of A closure is contained in closure of F of A. So here we have the first part. Now for the converse part, now we are going to take this. So conversely, let, okay, image of A closure is contained in closure of F of A here. For every subset A of X here. Now we want to show that the function F is continuous here. When we have this, that is F of A closure is contained in closure of F of A. So for that we consider this. So we take a closed subset of Y. So let F be any closed subset, let F be any closed subset of Y, or in Y here. So we write here, then closure of F is equal to F here. Then we write now this one. Now F inverse F now is a subset of X, and so by hypothesis we have, now since F inverse F, now this is subset of X here, and we know that for every subset A of X, we have F of closure of A is contained in closure of F of A. So actually this is a subset of X. So we write here, replacing A by now F inverse F. So we write here F inverse of F. Now closure of this set is contained in now closure of F inverse F here. Now this implies that, yes, we can write here F of F inverse of F closure. Now this is contained in actually F of F inverse F. So this is simply F. Okay, because F composite F inverse is identity. Okay, but we know that function F is closed. So F closure is equal to, we have F here. So this implies that we have F of, yes, closure of F inverse F. Now this is contained in function in set F here. Now applying F inverse on both the sets. So we write here, now closure of F inverse F. Now this is contained in F inverse F. But we know that, okay, now this set F inverse F is always containing now this set. So we write now this one, but now inverse image of set F is always containing now closure of F inverse F here. So using these two, we write here, therefore we write here F inverse F is equal to, we have now closure of F inverse F. So this tells us that this set F inverse F is closed set in X. Now here we have taken F as a closed subset of Y, and here we have proved that F inverse F is closed set in X. So this tells us that the function F is continuous, because we have the theorem F is continuous if and only if inverse image of closed set is closed. So here inverse image of set F, which is the closed set, okay, now F inverse F is closed set in X. So hence function F is continuous. Okay, thank you.